The underground installation of the cable is called the laying of underground cables. This is considered an important step. Even if we have an excellent construction of cable, the cable may get damaged if we are careless during this laying process. In today's video, I am going to talk about this laying of underground power cables. Hi, I am Vanilla and you are watching The Learning Curve. There are three main types of laying underground cables: direct laying, drawn system and the solid system. Let's first see about the direct laying. In this method, a trench of about 1.5 meters deep and 45 centimeters wide is dug. The trench is covered with a layer of fine sand of about 10 centimeters in thickness. The cable is laid over this sand bed. The sand prevents the entry of moisture from the ground and thus protects the cable from decay. After the cable has been laid in the trench, it is covered with another layer of sand of about 10 cm thickness. The trench is then covered with bricks and other materials in order to protect the cable from mechanical injury. When more than one cable is to be laid in the same trench, a horizontal or vertical interaxial spacing of at least 30 cm is provided to reduce the effect of mutual heating and ensure that a fault occurring on one cable does not damage the adjacent cable. This method of laying underground cable is simple and cheap and is much favored in modern practice. It gives the best condition for dissipating the heat generated in the cables. However, there are a few disadvantages to this system. The alterations in the cable network cannot be made easily. The maintenance cost is very high. Identifying the exact location of the fault is difficult. Now, let's move on to the draw-in system. This method of cable laying is suitable for congested areas such as busy roads where frequent digging is costlier or impossible. In this method, conduits or ducts are laid in the ground with manholes at suitable positions along the cable route. This is a four-way underground duct line. The cables are then pulled into position from manholes. Cable rollers are used to support the cable during the pulling. The distance between the manholes should not be too long so as to simplify the pulling in of the cables. The cables to be laid in this way need not be armored but must be provided with a serving in order to protect them when being pulled into the ducts. Once the conduits have been laid, alterations can be made without opening the ground. There are very less chance of fault occurrence due to the strong mechanical protection provided by the system. However, the initial cost is very high. The current carrying capacity of the cables is reduced due to the close grouping of cables and unfavorable conditions for dissipation of heat. Now let's get to a solid system. In this method of laying, the cable is laid in open pipes or troughs dug out in the earth along the cable route. After the cable is laid in position, the troughing is filled with a bituminous or asphaltic compound and covered over. Cables laid in this manner are usually plain lead covered because troughing affords good mechanical protection. This system is more expensive than the direct laid system. Due to poor heat dissipation facilities, the current carrying capacity of the cable is reduced. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.